On January 23rd, 2014, a mystery emerges that will take investigators from the deserts of Mars to the birth of one of the greatest civilizations on Earth.
There's an obvious crater in the landscape here in Mexico, but it's not so much the crater that catches my attention, it's what's inside this crater.
This is intriguing because what we're seeing is this white color, and boy, it sure does look like ice.
It's so unusual because we're talking about Mexico, and this white patch stays here all year round.
The mystery white crater is one of a cluster known as the Seven Luminaries, which, when viewed from above, mirror the Ursa Major constellation. To NASA's Kasha Patel, this extraterrestrial connection may be more than just coincidence.
This crater reminds me of something, but it's not on Earth. This crater looks pretty similar to the Korolev crater on Mars.
The Korolev crater in the northern lowlands of Mars contains enough water ice to fill almost a billion Olympic swimming pools.
Most of the ice found elsewhere on Mars is mixed with frozen carbon dioxide, but it appears that the icy regions in the Korolev crater are composed of more pure water.
The crater is named after visionary rocket scientist Sergei Korolev, who, during the Cold War, helped the Soviets to outsmart NASA by landing the first spacecraft on the moon. In a twist of fate, the space agency hopes his legacy will be key to the future human colonization of Mars.
Ice is such a precious commodity for humans. It can also be used as rocket fuel. If you can make hydrogen and oxygen on Mars, you fill your rocket for a one-way trip, and then you gas up on the other end, and you fly back to the Earth.
What stops the ice from melting during Mars's 70-degree Fahrenheit daytime temperatures is a process called cold trapping.
Cold air goes into the crater, and it forms sort of an insulating layer, so any of the water gets trapped there as water ice. Could we be seeing the same process in action in this image?
But our planet's atmosphere is 100 times thicker than on Mars, creating swirling winds which prevent cold trapping from taking place here in Mexico.
The Earth has a very dynamic atmosphere that tends to even out the environment. So this is something very different that we're looking at.
According to those who live nearby, the crater did once contain water, but it was bleach-like and killed everything it touched. To geologists, this suggests the mystery white substance is the legacy of a catastrophically powerful volcanic event.
This means the water inside this crater is extremely alkaline. That tells me that this is most likely sodium bicarbonate. It's very broad, but it's very shallow. This crater has all the classic features of a Mar volcano.
Mar volcanoes are formed by phreatic eruptions, which are known as the nuclear bombs of the natural world.
A Mar volcano occurs when shallow magma intrudes into an area that has a lot of groundwater. It creates an amazing amount of energy.
It vaporizes this water and it creates a steam explosion.
After the explosion, water fills into the bottom of the crater.
Sometimes you can get volcanic gases still seeping in, so you end up with this highly alkaline volcanic soup.
Over time, the ground around the crater dries out, concentrating the volcanic soup into a chemical sludge.
As that water evaporates, it concentrates it further until we get these large fields of crystals that form, which is what we see in the image.
Scientists have recently discovered the crater's floor is covered with a cyanobacteria called spirulina.
Spirulina itself is a very simple organism, but over history, it's been considered a superfood.
What we found is that the Aztecs used it as one of their primary food sources.
They'd harvest large quantities of it. They considered it the food of the gods.
Around 100,000 years after it devastated this part of Mexico, this strange white crater may have helped give rise to one of the greatest civilizations in history.
This is almost like a museum of the Earth's earliest prehistory. It's a fascinating place.
July 18th, 2019. High above Kansas, eyes in the sky capture something out of place in a farming community far below.
At first glance, it looks normal. But if you look closer, there's some structures here that a farmer would not have on their homestead.
A double security fence surrounds a 105-foot diameter flat concrete platform. And a close analysis of the approach road reveals this is no ordinary structure.
Paying attention to the shadows is really important here. Where the road comes into the compound, the shadows really give the impression that the road doesn't stay flat, but actually dips down. Is this compound hiding secrets that are somehow related to a more sinister purpose?
Military analyst Carlo Munoz finds some historic images that seem to confirm that this rural landscape conceals a terrifying secret.
The remote location, the security perimeter, what looks like an underground bunker, it is the launch site for a nuclear missile.
Declassified military records confirm this location was one of a series of top secret bunkers. Armed with Atlas E nuclear missiles.
The Atlas missiles were the first intercontinental ballistic missiles armed with enough destructive power to destroy a city the size of Moscow or St. Petersburg.
What puzzles analysts is that the Atlas E was mothballed in 1964. But the missile silo doesn't appear to be abandoned.
If you look at the satellite images, you'll see the road, you see the cars, you see a digger, so you know there's activity happening at this site right now.